Elizabeth St. Hilaire is back with her second release of Klimt-inspired masks and stencils, this time a group of 7. We have them available as open stock, or you can grab a set of them all. Plus, we have the original release of 10 stencils and masks that you can also buy individually or grab a set. In today's video, I'll show you each of the new styles along with some fun techniques to use with them. Gustav Klimt is Elizabeth's favorite artist, and you've probably seen her first collection of Klimt-inspired stencils and masks we released a few months ago. I want to say it was summertime, August-ish, 2021. And she's once again turned to Klimt as for her muse, and this time a group of 7 designs are the result. So each was drawn by Elizabeth specifically for this release, and there is 1 stencil and 6 masks in the group. So I'm going to show them to you in alpha order, and then we'll get to playing. So this is the first design, and it's named Garden. Excuse me, I'm sorry, this one is Forest. Here's Garden. This is the one that's a true stencil. It's got these flowers on it. I think of this kind of curvy area as a path, so Garden Path. Anyway, that's Garden, and then up next is one that's named Looking Glass. Now what I like about this is that it's a mask in a frame, but up top here all you have are these wonderful spiral curly designs, no frame needed, so you get a very different look depending on which edge you're looking at. Alright, and then this one is a little bit different take on a mask. It's named Medicine, and there's no frame on the sides. Instead, there's just one on the top and the bottom that kind of connects all of these wonderful elements in the center. And then up next, this is named Serpents, kind of fun design, very simple but very effective. I actually am going to show that to you in a moment. I've got some samples of various designs that I've worked on so far. So that one is Serpents, and then up next is Secession. That's this one here. You can see there's some paint and some sprays on it because I've been playing. And then finally, the last one is named The Kiss, and you'll recognize this because obviously the portrait that is named, or the painting that is named The Kiss, was the obvious inspiration for that. Alright, so I said I have some samples. Let me go ahead and show those to you. So if I bring them out here kind of in a pile, in some kind of sensible order. So here's the one that was made with serpents, and you can see that this is just a very simple, very effective design. Alright, so this was made with Garden. Let's spread these out. So here's where I printed this through the openings of this stencil when I had it on a gel press plate. And here's what I got when I printed the design afterward. And then this was another one that I just was playing with. And so you can see here are the samples of the stencil that's named Garden. Let's slip those out of the way. So this one is from the design that's named Secession, and what I did, this is our printable rice paper, so it's very thin and very absorbent, and I went ahead and I sprayed through Secession, and then I printed what was left, which is how I got this. And then, what do we got next here? This one is Looking Glass, so you can see some designs here. You get a little bit of it here, or you get a bigger section of it here. You can see there's these occasional spoked areas, and I've highlighted them here. So which area of the mask you decide to focus on means you're going to get a little bit of a different look. And obviously I've gone around this one with black to kind of highlight it and make it stand up off the background. All right, so the last one that I'm going to show you, well, let's put these over here. The last one I'm going to show you for this moment is the one that was named Medicine. Now I'm going to turn this one this way. It makes a little bit more sense. And I have to be honest, I was prepared not to be in love with this particular mask until I worked with it. And then I printed it on some black and came in and outlined it with some white and did a little bit of white doodling and some white text. And I got to tell you, I really love that design. And here's another example of it, this time printed. This is one of our number 10 watercolor tags. Same kind of thing. I went through there with black this time and just outlined the design to really make them kind of stand out. So the first technique I'm going to show you is a simple one where I'm just going to spray through the openings, and then I'll take that one step further by turning it over and printing it. And I'm going to start with the one that is named The Kiss. This actually goes this way. So I have a piece. This is, you know what, this is my Serpent's stunt sample, but let's just go ahead and work with this. So this is art by Marlene. This is her all-purpose paper pad, and it's an A4 size. Now technically A4 is a little bit smaller in both directions than a 9x12 stencil, but that's fine. This will work just fine. Since I don't want to lose this area up here, what I'm going to do is resign myself to losing just a little tiny bit down here. All right, so I'm gonna just grab a couple of oxide sprays. I have cracked pistachio and kicked raspberry. Just go ahead and give them a shake. Now obviously pink and green would make mud if I mixed them, but I'm just gonna overlap them without doing a lot of mixing, and I don't wanna overspray because if I do, I'm gonna make a mess and then I'll be unhappy. And we definitely don't want that. All right, so that's probably enough. All right, so if I pick this up, actually, let me use a palette knife. It'll be easier. My cap rolls off the table. And how pretty is that? You can see the design. It's just marvelous. Now, obviously, Klimt worked a lot with gold in his paintings and his various creations. So you could come in and you could add some gold paint, gold leaf. You could really do anything. And you can use the actual portrait that's named The Kiss as an inspiration. All right, so let me grab some paper towels and go ahead and wipe this up. Now there's spray left on the top of that mask. So what I'm going to do is bring it in and turn it over and go ahead and print. Now rather than just printing and calling it done, I'm going to let that go where it fell. What I'm going to do instead is press this down so I get good contact between the ink or the spray that's on that stencil and the paper. But rather than just call this done the way it is, let's bring in, this is peacock feathers, and I'm gonna spray through the openings this way, and it's just another way to take advantage of what you've got and make something really interesting with it. And I'm probably gonna call that done. I don't know how much we'll see. Oh, actually we saw more than I thought. Because I didn't go super heavy with the green and the pink, there wasn't a lot left on the stencil, but you can certainly see what happens there. And if you have more on the stencil, then you'll obviously see more of the color, like in here. All right, so again, let's go ahead and clean this up. And then the last thing I'm gonna do, and then in the next segment, I'll come back and we'll work with a gel press plate. But the thing I'm gonna do next, all right, let's move that over there. And I need to grab medicine. All right, so here's medicine. Now, you wouldn't think, let's get that completely out of the way so it doesn't make a mess. You wouldn't think at first blush that something like, gosh, there's sprays everywhere, that something like a powder would work particularly well with a stencil, but in fact they do. So another piece of Marlene's all-purpose paper, and before I forget to mention it, we have all of the Art by Marlene products. Let's turn this way. All of the Art by Marlene products are 20% off with a selected group of them like the Advent Calendar and some others that are actually 35% off. All right, so Pixie Sparkles. I have Groovy Grape and Teal Marine. And I'm just going to go ahead and sprinkle these through the openings of the stencil. Now, like the last technique, where what is left on top of the stencil can be printed, depending on how much of the Pixie Sparkles you get on the Mylar will allow you to go ahead and print it after the fact. All right, let's put a little bit of purple down here, a little bit more of the teal wash, and obviously you can do this with any kind of a spray or, excuse me, any kind of a powder. It doesn't have to be Pixie Sparkles. All right, so if I bring in, here is my water bottle, and I'm just going to lightly mist this, just enough to activate the color. And again, I'll grab my palette knife, which will help me pick this up without making a giant mess. And how pretty is that? Now, this is going to be even better once it dries and you can really see the sparkle. And I'll take some photos of these and we'll put them up on Instagram and wherever else they end up. So if I grab my paper towel again and just kind of wipe this up. Now, ordinarily, I wouldn't waste that, but for the sake of getting it done, I'm going to. And I grab yet another piece of this and go ahead and turn medicine over. I can print what's on there. All right, let's reel some of this off. And now I can just come back and roll. The point here is I want there to be good contact between the underside of that stencil or mask and the surface that I'm trying to print it on. And there you go. You get the positive this time because the design itself is colored. And again, this will be, you can see some of the glimmer, but mostly what you see right now is that it's wet. This will be, the glimmer, the shimmer will be much more obvious once this is dry. As I said a moment ago, it wouldn't be a stencil video without bringing in a gel press plate. And next, I'm going to use the mask named Garden to make another print. In the last segment, I said I was going to use Garden as my stencil for, or my mask, for the gel press plate example, but instead I'm going to use Forest. I've already printed with Garden, and the samples are here somewhere, and I haven't done anything with Forest, so that's what I'm going to do. I have two colors of Amsterdam Acrylic Paint. We have this on sale at 25% off, and then I have one color of Hilaire Art Alchemy Paint. This one is Dark Forest. This is turquoise green, and this is quinacridone rose. So to make this kind of interesting, I'm going to make, it kind of amps up the wow factor. I'm going to make a gradation for the background, and I'm once again using the paper from Marlene's all-purpose paper pad. This is, again, A4. It is a little bit bigger than an 8x10 plate, so that works out just fine. So when I do a gradation, it's very straightforward, and in this case, pink and turquoise are going to make purple, so I'm not worried about the mix in the center. If you are, then you just have to kind of make an effort to get your color on there and then brayer it and then go ahead and get a little bit of a mix in the center. All right, I need to get myself a piece of scrap paper off to the side, which I can do up there. So I'm going to start by working, it doesn't make any difference which color. I'm going to work on one of the colors, and now I'm going to come across and I'm going to grab the turquoise. I'm actually going to roll some of that off because I want to come over here. Let's turn it this way so I don't move the pink over here too far. And I'll just let that kind of blend in the center. That looks good to me. It doesn't have to be perfect. So I will go ahead and print this. And there's probably enough paint on there to pull up a ghost print. So there's my original print, my gradation. You can see the purple in the center. And here's my ghost print. Alright, so that pretty well cleans that off. Now you can see I've got some interesting things going on here in the background because it started to lift a little bit of the smudge that's left from whatever I did the last. So I'm going to just go ahead and brayer the color off. And while I'm talking, these will dry a little bit. So up next, I'm going to bring in the dark green. Go ahead and grab a palette knife and spread a layer of this out. Grab a piece of paper towel to wipe that off. All right, so this is straightforward. It's just a single layer. And I find, I'm going to put a little bit more paint than this. I find that it's important that there be really strong contrast between this second layer and whatever your background is, because otherwise you're just not going to see the imagery quite as well. And what's the point of going through all this work and then not seeing it? All right, so I'm not going to brayer this off just for a second. I'm going to push that over to one side and bring in Forest. And let's see what I'm doing here. I think I'm going to do it like this. Obviously, this stencil is bigger than an 8x10 plate. You can solve that by using a bigger plate if you want. Now, what I'm going to do, there are times when I might pull this through to something that I'm going to save. Pull this paint through is what I meant. But for this, I'm not going to. All I want to do is clean the paint that's in the open areas of the mask out, and that might require, but you can see how interesting this is. That's probably going to require that I come back and I grab another piece of paper to do that. I want this to be as clean as possible so that pink and turquoise gradation show as much as possible through those openings. And the way to do that is to clean that paint out as much as possible. All right, so that looks pretty good. I'm going to take this off. And now I'll come back, and here is my first layer. And that's pretty close, or close enough in this case. Just go ahead and print that, and then we'll see if we've got enough left to do a ghost print. Oh, how awesome is that? See, it's really important that you have strong contrast. I'm not even going to try to pull a second print. I can see that this is too dry, and I'm not going to get anything out of it. But this is just fantastic. Again, you have nice contrast, you have that gradation in the background, so it makes for a really interesting design. Now, something else that's really interesting, and what I'm going to do, well, that's not going to get us anywhere. So, what I was going to do, let's move this out of the way. What I was going to do is not drop my stencil, is just come in and go ahead and mist this with a little, well, hold on one second while I pick up my gel press plate. Now maybe it will stay. So the point, what I'm trying to do here is capture what's on this mask. And by doing what I just did, which was to mist it with a little bit of water, I might keep that paint damp enough to do something with it. So I'm just going to grab a piece of printer paper because I don't expect to get much out of this, but ideally, in a perfect world, I would have done this a little bit sooner, although I'm seeing some stuff here that tells me I might get a decent print. We'll see. Okay, so that's not bad. Had there been a little bit more paint and I had used a nicer piece of paper, this would obviously be something usable. This is just cheapo printer paper. But you can see this is another possible outcome. This is another possible thing that you can do with the paint that's left on here. So I'm just going to quickly miss this. I'm going to cap my green paint so that it doesn't dry out, because that's never a good thing. Let's toss that and get that out of the way. And just come in and lightly wipe this off. Sometimes it's easier to just go ahead and throw this in a container of water. It makes for cleaning, it makes cleaning far, far easier. Right, let's just kind of wipe off this back. All right, good enough. Let's get this out of the way so we can move on to the next thing. Now, something else that you can do is if you want to deliberately do what I just did, and here's the serpent's design, what you can do is get some color on a brayer, roll it over there, and then go ahead and do it. But if you're going to roll it over there, you might as well make it worth your while. So I'm going to put down a piece of the Art by Marlene paper, get that serpent's mask kind of lined up on there, and now let's just come back and I'll grab the same pink and blue. I'm going to put some color out. And I'm going to go ahead and brayer it. And I'm not going to get fancy in terms of worrying about the gradation. I'm just going to go ahead and brayer it. And I want to be pretty liberal with my paint. I don't want there to be too little. So I'm not going to get a super duper impression necessarily through the stencil when I do this. But you get a background, which sometimes, oh, that's pretty cool. Sometimes you just get the beginnings of a background. So I'm going to flip this over because it's not great, but we'll hold on to it. And I'm going to come through and I'm going to miss this. Oops, be nice if my water didn't fall over. And now I'm just going to come and print this. And my expectation is that I'll get a result that's a little bit nicer. Let's get some paper towel here. I'll get a result that's a little bit nicer. Although, quite honestly, I'm working haphazardly here, so we will see what we will see. So I'm going to go ahead and press this. Let's do it this way. Grab some paper towel and just go ahead and press this. If I had a clean brayer, I could actually use the brayer, but my hands work just as well. So this isn't, see, how cool is that? So this is just a way that you can, another way that you can use your stencils. And then the final thing I want to show you, and I need to clean this up, let's toss that over there, go ahead and wipe this up, is how you can use a stencil and make an interesting print by brayering over the top of something thin. And in this case, my thin is going to be, let me grab, what stencil am I using here? I guess I'm going to use Looking Glass because that's the first thing that's clean and dry that I can get my hands on. So I've got Looking Glass here. What I'm going to do is grab a piece of our printable rice paper. For this technique to work, you need a reasonably thin top layer. So I'm going to lay this on here, and I'm going to, because I've got that top edge that doesn't have the frame and I want to see that, I'm going to align it so I get that and I'm less worried about what's going on down here. So the way to do this is to grab a couple of colors of paint, and why not metallic? So this is one of the Amsterdam Acrylic Metallic paints. And this is, well, this is that pink again. So what I'm going to do is hopefully get something that looks like this. I did this with, this is the forest design. All right, so if I, well, let's brayer that off. So I'm using a reasonably clean brayer. Again, I just want to go ahead and get this color out. And all I'm going to do is press and roll. Now, I had too much paint here, but you can see what happens. You get the pattern, and I didn't align that particularly well, but you get the pattern of the stencil through the thin paper, which in this case is rice paper. And the thinner this paper is, the better. For example, this Marlene's paper, which is, good grief, it's got to be, I don't know, 140 pound. This would probably, well, you know what, we'll try it. I was going to say, this would probably work, but I think it's probably a little bit too thick. So this, I think, is the stencil named Secession. I can't remember at this point, but I'm going to lay it down. I'm going to grab some of this paint and go ahead and press. Yeah, and you can see it doesn't work nearly as well. It's really important that you use a thin paper, and this is a much better example because I did it and I was taking my time, but you can see how effective this is. Just another opportunity to play with these designs, because there's so many ways that you can use a stencil, but sometimes it's interesting to be reminded about something that you might not have done in a while. These are the new Stencils and Masks from Elizabeth St. Hilaire's Klimt 2 collection, and they're debuting today at joggles.com.